My name is Jan Goldring, and I'm going to tell you about an important event in my life. I've been practicing gymnastics for as long as I can remember, and I've always dreamt of the big competitions. And now, I had qualified for the Olympic World Championship with my team. We're the world's best team. I'd do anything for my teammates. It was me, my two best friends and teammates, and our coach Stieg that went to the competition in Helsingborg. We had practiced hard, and we were in the best shape of our lives. We were so good that we made it all the way to the final. We had nothing to lose, so we were joking around in the locker room as usual. Our opponent in the final was the USA, and they were not happy types, you could tell. We all hushed because they looked so dangerous. I think it was because their coach looked to be a real grouch. Maybe he was hungry. So I asked if he wanted a banana, but no, that he did not. Okay, go on being a grump, I said, and we left, because it was warm-up time. We got an area on the floor where we could put our bags and warm up. That's important. We did our warm-up program, which we always do together. Now we were ready to compete. But first, we had to defile. You always defile before a competition. You march through the tournament hall to the beat of marching music, carrying a flag up front. It's important, I think, because it's been done at all the competitions I've been to. Team gym has three different disciplines. The first discipline is trompette. When we saw the high scores, we got excited and shouted in falsetto. That's the way it works. But then the US gymnasts did their routine, and they were even better, so they scored higher than us. But they didn't scream, and they didn't look happy at all. They looked even grouchier than we, who were obviously a bit disappointed. But at least we're in second place, our coach said encouragingly, and then we got excited again. Yeah, there's no point in moping. It's downright stupid to be sad when you just did really well. The second discipline involves doing tricks on a long mat. That's why it's called tumbling. He should have eaten a whole bunch of bananas, as grumpy as he was. But now it was our turn. I couldn't believe that we actually had a chance of beating the USA. We did our coolest tricks and scored even better than the US. I must have gotten confused in all my euphoric joy, because I wasn't looking in front of me and I stumbled, fell, and sprained my foot. Bad. There I sat in the locker room in pain. Though the pain in my foot wasn't as bad as the one in my heart. Now we couldn't finish the competition. Our coach came and asked if I could compete. I wanted to, but I couldn't. He clapped his hands together, rubbed them, and started to massage my foot. Magically, the foot felt okay again. I jumped up and shouted to the guys, "Are you ready to compete?" The third and last discipline is the floor program. You have to do movements and tricks right on the floor, simultaneously and to the beat of the music. But it's not dancing. In the end, there was only my solo trick left. I focused, and on our coach's signal, I did my brand new secret trick that had never been done before. The hall erupted into screams of joy. No one had ever seen anything like it. Our score was sky high, and believe it or not, we won. We won the Olympic World Championships over the United States of America. That's my story. I hope to see you this fall at the European Championships. Then it's Denmark we're going to beat.